Well, hey everyone, it's Rain again with another installment to my wedding vlog series. If you're new to the Anointed to Bling channel, welcome aboard. I hope you'll stick around and subscribe. If you're not, I want to thank you for tuning in again. It's much appreciated. Today, I want to share with you this Pinterest-inspired vase project that is very near and dear to my heart in commemoration of my father, my stepfather, my spiritual father, my youngest brother, and my mother-in-law, who all passed away prior to the wedding, most of them last year. But these can be used for your end tables, nightstands. You can definitely use these as home decor or party decor. If you want to find out how easy this is to make at a very nominal cost, stay tuned for the tutorial. It's coming up right now. Down below where you can get all of the details. I apologize for it being so dark. I'm outside at night, but here I am just spray painting those boxes as well as the vases, which I did off camera. Just as a note, the spray paint did work on these boxes, but it wasn't quite as rich as I liked, so I did go back with the black acrylic paint and paint over it before I moved on. So here I'm just preparing to lay that mirror on top of this particular box. And just as a side note, if you ever want to make a mirror box, this is a good box to use for that. I like the sturdiness of it, and you'll have it forever. It'll last you a lot longer as opposed to some of the ways I've seen it done in other tutorials. Anyway, I'm taking that E6000 and just running it around the sides of the box, and I'm just gonna lay that mirror flat on top of it. Now you'll find the mirror is just a teeny bit bigger than the box itself, but it really doesn't get in the way of the design and it doesn't hinder anything, so I didn't mind that at all. And I'm just gonna let that sit until it's completely dry. It wouldn't be me if I didn't have embellishments, so I am taking this gold bling that I got at Hobby Lobby and laying a nice little strip of about 6 across the lower quarter of the box, and then I'm going to go back and add 2 strips around the edges of the mirror. So what I did off camera is I added a little bling around the bottom of the jar in 1 strip, and then along the neck of the jar, of the largest one, I did about 8 strips, and of the smallest one, I did about 4, just to give it a nice little design and really tie into the box. So here I'm just taking that epoxy and I'm spreading it over the bottom of this jar because I want to attach this to the box. Now you certainly don't have to do this. You can keep those boxes separate and use them as stackers. I chose to build this because I wanted to be a complete set, and I wanted to be to be all connected. And I did get a little bit too much of the epoxy on the bottom of that jar, so I'm just spreading it out on the second jar as well, so as not to waste it. And the reason you don't want too much epoxy is you don't want things to slide. When you lay it, you want it to be tacky, but you don't want it to be so thick that it ends up sliding across the mirror and not centering for you later. And so here I'm just placing that to the best of my ability in the center of that box. I'm gonna let that sit until it's completely adhered to the box itself. Was waiting for things to dry, I wanted to make an arrangement for this particular project. I'll explain a little bit more about that, but I used the vase to draw a circle around the bottom of the ball where I'm going to leave the opening, so it will sit nice and flush against the top of that vase. And all I did was stick the roses that I got from the Dollar Tree and Hobby Lobby in there, pulling them out, adding a little E6000, and then reattaching that rose. This is so that they will not fall out, but so that this will stay. And yes, I do plan to keep this arrangement forever, which I'll explain in the next clip. And so here we are at the finished product. I am so proud of how this came out. I still have to do a smaller, probably 6-inch rose bouquet to put on top of the little one. But back in July, my youngest brother was murdered. And while we were at the funeral home trying to prepare for his services, we were looking and trying to decide what kind of flowers we should have, because he really wasn't so much of a flower guy. And being that we're spiritual people, preachers, pastors, ministers, counselors, my sister was sitting there and she heard just 219 in her spirit, and she felt that my brother Dathan was visiting her and saying 219. So she just bust out, whatever 219 is, that's the one. So we didn't know if it was page 219, if it was arrangement number 219, but my mom continued to flip through the book, and lo and behold, there was an arrangement for 219, and it was a beautiful cascade of roses. And so we decided at that time that as we had different events for our weddings or parties or holidays, we would always make sure to have red roses to commemorate his memory. So I actually plan to keep this ball in my home in commemoration of my brother and those others that we lost this year. So it really is a project that's near and dear to my heart, and it's definitely a great way to celebrate your loved ones. I found these beautiful little angels at the Goodwill when I was picking up these vases, and I thought, how perfect. So I grabbed some candles from the dollar store, you know, and put a little bling around it to kind of tie it all in. But I'm really pleased with how this came out. I love it. I really, really, really love it. This is about a 12-inch ball, so it's really big, which is what I wanted. But I hope you like this project. Excuse me. Really short, quick, easy, simple, to the point. If you decide to make this, please tag me. I'd love to see your work. And until next time, remember, you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. Until next project, thank you for visiting, and I'll see you again soon. You guys be blessed. Have a great day.